Hello, we're back again. I don't even know. Today is the 20th, correct? And we took 14, 15, 16, 17, 14, 15, 16. We have had the last 5, 6 days without doing any videos for that. We apologize. But we just had a lot of stuff going on. But we're back into the groove now. Of course, that didn't mean we weren't working. We meant to take a couple of days off. Every 2 weeks we were planning on taking a day or two off. But due to things coming up and other things, we didn't get a chance to record any videos until now. But I have been working. I've been working on my YouTube page and Facebook page, getting them working correctly. Our Facebook and YouTube pages.
We've been dealing with spirits.
We're dealing with a lot of spirits. Lots.
Spirits and
people. Physical people.
Physical people asking questions. I've been writing a lot of questions and stuff up for the show. Coming up when we interview people.
We have some interviews coming up with people. I want to say a guy named Tony is going to be on here soon. Take a look at some of my videos on my Facebook page with the tall, kind of dark-skinned dude. The short, light-skinned dude's name is Cecil, but Tony is a tall, dark-skinned dude. He's going to be here. He's a long time, very close friend of mine, and he's going to be interviewing him about his music and hopes and dreams and his spiritual lessons that he's beginning to fall into place in his life, things he's beginning to realize and be exposed to. He's been around us a lot.
He's a very charismatic fellow. When he's rapping, he's really into it. I mean, he's in his zone.
He has star power.
Yeah, star power, yeah. He definitely has it in him to make something of himself, and we're encouraging of that for him.
Yeah, indeed, we do. We encourage Tony to keep it up, and Tony's an excellent psychic, too, and he's beginning to be able to sense spirits, and he's seen some of them, too.
Yeah.
Beginning to do that, too. And it's just from being around, and I think our energy has passed to him. I know it has.
I feel that. Yeah.
It's been passed to him, and it helps turn him on. And he's excited about it. But Tony will be on probably tomorrow or the next day. And I think we're going to talk to Cecil too.
I'm excited.
And
about
we have a girl named Tony who does beats. Mm-hmm. Who just very well might come on here.
Yeah.
Like Tony, the male Tony, is saying he talked to the female Tony.
Yeah.
Regarding her coming on.
Let's get them all on.
Now, Peanut, if you're watching this, I apologize for not getting there. It's last Sunday. I'm going to get into what happened Sunday in just a minute. But I want you to come on here so we can talk to you about your music, man. A lot of people watch these videos, and we want to help you. I want to talk to you about your music and your other things, whatever you feel like talking about.
Yeah,
and Red, too. Oh, Ready Rock, that's what he calls himself. For those of y'all who knew Ready Rock from the South Side, young dude, light skinned dude, rapper, I've known him for years. And
I mean, it's our time. It's our time.
I'm trying to help him out.
Yeah, it's our time for people to shine, to step out of their
comfort zone.
Yeah, their comfort zones, and they come out and shine for once. So let's get some people in the bright light,
Oh, yeah.
Let's get that positive flow going, with people in general, just not just music, not just talent, but in every aspect. If we can help you get the ball rolling in a positive way, that's what we're here to help.
And we got to give props to Chi-Chi for this, his get-togethers party next weekend at Club Down Under. I think it's on South 12th Street. Like the same thing he's been doing all spring with having various underground rappers from around Richmond, so forth, come and perform, including his group, which I believe is called Young Richmond Outcasts.
Right.
And that's Chi-Chi's group, along with some other people, and used to be Mike was in the group too. Mike was in that one, Mike Easy.
peace to Mike Easy, man. We love you, man. You know, and you know, for those, Mike's still around. Mike is not dead. That's and for anyone that dies, no one's dead that died. That's just you know.
Right.
Mike's just as alive as can be. This is another dimension. I can assure you that. And goes for any of y'all and the people who died. But we'll get back to this. We talked about that a lot too. But shout out to, speaking of Mike, shout out, we got a shout out to Cameron White. Cam's doing his own comedy show, which is next Saturday, I found. It's not Saturday, Sunday, so we're going to be able to go to both Saturday night and Sunday night next weekend. And I think, I forgot what it is exactly. I don't want to give the wrong club name, but look it up on his Facebook if you know what it is.
Yeah.
You give him some support, you know. You know, support Cam on this because, you know, he does good comedy. He's a funny, funny young brother, and he deserves this. And Jeremy and I and Tony Cecil, hopefully, and as many people as we can bring, we're going to try to bring some support out.
Yeah.
You know, for you, Cam. So just wanted you to know that too.
Absolutely.
And of course, to Red, you know. I know you keep doing your shows. I think you say you're going to be filming a video next week or a week after. We got to catch up with you too, man.
Yeah.
I've been proud of this young brother, man, for so long. I knew him when he was little. He was a young kid around San Susie. I lived over there. He lived over there. A lot of other people. And, you know, people used to fuck with him. You know, he's already right, man. He's like, fuck with Red, say, oh, you're never going to make it. You ain't going to be no rapper. You know, you're just dreaming. You're nobody. You know, no listen to you. But I always taught Red, don't take that for an answer. Fuck haters.
Yeah.
You know, and to keep doing it anyway. If you love to rap, you need to rap.
Exactly.
No matter what.
No matter what. Anybody says, thanks, feels.
This goes not for just for Red, but for everyone. Yeah. Do what you love, no matter what anyone says. And basically, Ryan took that to his heart, and, you know, I'm very proud of Red now, and for what he's doing, and he's going to go places psychically, I can tell you, going all of it, but, you know, Red's going to be a superstar.
He's a long and windy road. Long and windy road ahead of him.
Yeah, it's going to be windy, and there'll be ups and downs, but... But he's going to be a superstar, right? It's coming.
Yeah.
Trust me. You know, not just for him. There's other people I can see.
Yeah.
And to Cameron, you'll be a comedian superstar. Man.
I feel that.
You know, and same with Tony. And the Peanut, you would be there right along with Red. You know, you should know that. You know. You'll be there. We psychically, we had a vision of you. Jeremy had a vision of you and Red on a TV show, a particular TV show. Actually, it was our TV show.
Yeah,
it was our TV show. I think it was on MTV or something like that. You know, and an upcoming future. We're not trying to sound arrogant. We had our own TV show.
Yeah.
And we have our own TV show.
Yeah.
You know, and we're on there healing people's emotions and.
Yeah.
Feelings and having, talking psychic stuff, spiritual stuff, talking about the spirit worlds, aliens, whatever comes up, like kind of like we do now. You know?
That's right.
You know?
I wanted to
talk for a minute while I write that.
I wanted to share with the audience my presence of aliens the other night. You know, I was laying in the bed and all of a sudden I got an eerie feeling. You know, just like one of these real eerie feelings, like something was going on. And it got stronger to the point where I was almost scared, you know, like, what is going on? And I kept seeing, like, images in my mind of these gray aliens. Well, as soon as I got real scared, I fell asleep. And I don't remember what happened. But I think we figured it out under hypnosis.
Jeremy and I, we worked together to hypnotize him, and while I probed it and went through his mind, to find out what happened after he said that he fell asleep,
and when he
was scared seeing the aliens,
it was
and we found out,
it was an interesting